welcome Susan and Andy.
You're walking along the street, or you're at a party, or else you're alone, and then you suddenly dig. You're looking in someone's eyes, you suddenly realize that this could be the start of something big.
You're lunching at 21, watching your diet, declining a shot and ruse, accepting a fake. When out of the clear blue sky, it's suddenly gal and guy.
And this could be the start of something big.
There's no controlling the unrolling of your fate, my friend. Who knows what's written in the magic book?
But when a lover you discover at the gate, my friend, invite her in without a second look.
You're up in an aeroplane, you're dining at Sardines, or lying in Malibu alone on the sand. You suddenly hear a bell, and right away you can tell
that this could be the start of something grand. This could be the start of something very big. Why don't you take a chance? Come try romance with me and see. This could be the start of something wonderful. Why don't you play your part? Come give your heart to me and see.
You're watching the sun come up, count your money, or else in a dim cafe, you're ordering wine. Then suddenly there he is, and you want to be where he is.
And this must be the start of something. This could be the heart of something. This could be the start of something.
String around my finger.
What a world, what a life, I'm in love.
I got a song that I sing, I can make the ring go anytime I move my finger.
Lucky me, can't you see I'm in love? Life's a wonderful thing, long as I hang on to the string. I'd be a silly so-and-so if I should ever let it go.
You know, you can never let go.
The world on a string, sitting on a rainbow.
Got that string around my finger.
What a world, what a life I am in. It's a beautiful thing.
Life is a wonderful thing.
Long as I hang on to a string, I'd be a silly so-and-so if I would ever let it go.
Never let it go.
I've got the world on a string,
and I'm sitting on a rainbow. Got that string around my finger.
What a world.
Now, I'm in love.
I'm gonna love you like nobody's loved you. Come rain or come shine. When you met me, it was just one of those things.
One of those things.
But don't you dare to bet me, 'cause I'm gonna be true if you will let me. You're gonna love me like nobody's loved me.
Like nobody's loved me.
Come rain or come shine.
Rain or come shine.
Happy together.
Happy together.
And won't that be fine?
Won't it be fine?
We might be in, we might be out of the money, but I'm with you always. I'm with you, rain or shine.
To tens of people. We do appreciate you being part of our audience. We really do. Remember, you know, whatever you do is going to be on film forever. If you pass gas, don't worry. It's not smell-o-vision. Everything's going to be fine.
I can't take you anywhere.
So, ladies and gentlemen, we are Andy and Susan. And you are? Oh, Lakes of Delta. I guess we don't have enough time to do the individual thing, right? Again, so what we do, basically, is sing. That's it. The dancing part of the show is finished, sir. There won't be any more choreography tonight. I know you missed it, but we're not doing any more. We're going to sing. We're going to sing some of our favorites. We're starting off with some songs that you are probably familiar with, right? We may not end up there. But now keep in mind, we are videotaping this. So, as you know, there's an editing process. So hang in with us. We got to do about 4 hours, so we do about an hour's worth. Hopefully you don't have plans tonight. I think 3 G's closes at what, 10? Oh, 8, so that's just, forget it, it's over. Anyway, we'll try to get you out of here as much under 4 hours as we can. Okay? We love duets. Do you love duets? That's what we're bringing you tonight. And we like duets that are obvious. We like some that aren't so obvious. This is a song that Lou Rawls made famous. You remember Lou Rawls? So we're going to turn it into a duet for you tonight. You're welcome, sir. You're very polite. Come on, everybody get closer to each other. This is a closeness song. You'll never find, as long as you live, someone who loves you the way that I do.
And you'll never find, no matter where you search, someone who cares about you the way I do.
And I'm not bragging on myself, baby, 'cause you're the one who loves you, and there is no one else. No.
Take the end of all time, someone who cares about you tender like I do.
And I'm not trying to make you stay, baby, 'cause I'm the one who loves you, and there is no one else.
See if you remember this one.
Well, you just roll
It used to be so natural to talk about forever. But used to be's don't count anymore. They lay on the floor till we sweep them away.
Baby, I remember all the things you taught me.
Well, I learned how to laugh, and I learned how to cry.
Well, I learned how to love, even learned how to lie.
So you'd think I could learn
how to tell you goodbye. You don't bring me flowers anymore.
Well, you think I could learn. You don't say you need me.
You don't sing me love songs. You don't bring me flowers
anymore. So, I don't want to make anybody feel bad, but we've been married a very, very long time. As a matter of fact, I don't think there's anybody in this room who could possibly have been married as long as she and I have been married. This September, just bear with me, I know it's going to be hard to believe. This September, we will be celebrating our 25th anniversary. I know. I guarantee you there's no couple in this room that's married longer than 25 years. Let me just see, by a show of hands, can we have some house lights there, Mike, please, if you don't mind? By a show of hands, if you've been married for longer than 25 years, hold your. All right, wait a minute. Longer than 30 years. 35. 40. What? 45. 50. Keep them up. 50. Keep. 60 years. Hold on, Susan. We have to redo our whole act. We can't do the next three songs. 70. Stop it. I said 70.
That's okay.
All right, hold on. 69, though. I think you're in the lead. Anybody else? Still. 70 years. 70 going once. Where? How long have you been married back there? 72 years. 72 years. What's the secret to your longevity, if I may ask? Hold on, I can't hear. Hold on. Because, you know, we're kind of far away. It's a secret. You've been very helpful, sir. That's how he manages to stay. 72 years. I don't know, that's not really a marriage. That's like a jail sentence. Just kidding. God bless you. That's fantastic. All of you. This is for you. You make me feel so young. You make me feel like spring has sprung. And every time I see you grin, I'm a happy individual.
The moment that you speak me, I wanna go play hide and seek. I wanna go and bounce the moon just like a toy balloon.
Because you and I are just like a couple of times.
dance.
You make me feel so young.
You make me feel there are songs to be sung, lots of bells to be rung, and a wonderful thing to be fun. And even when I'm old and gray, I'm gonna feel the way I do. Me feel like spring has sprung, and every time I see you grin, I'm such a cuckoo individual.
The moment that you speak, I wanna go play hide and seek. I wanna go and bounce the moon like a toy balloon.
Show tonight, we have about another 3 hours. We did a lot of research on what we thought were some really great duets. You know what we found? Thank you for asking. We found that some really great duets came from movies, from film, and specifically animated movies, believe it or not. So we're going to do a couple of our favorites from you. The first one is from a beautiful movie called okay. 25 years of marriage will do it to you. Tail? Something? Help me out, Jackie.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, anyway. The second one is much more recognizable.
Move on.
Fievel, yeah, you know. You got an American Tale.
Yeah,
oh. Oh, you helped
what
me out with
the
Fievel. You're my pal right there.
Yes.
Yeah, you get a little extra something after the show. Hope you enjoy Somewhere Out There, and the second one will be a surprise.
On that same bright star, and when the night winds starts to sing the lonesome lullaby. It helps to think we're sleeping underneath that same big sky.
Somewhere out there, if love can see us through, then we'll be together.
Somewhere out there, out where dreams come true.
And even though I know how very far apart we are, it helps to think we might be wishing on that same bright star.
And when the night wind starts to sing the lonesome lullaby, it helps to think we're sleeping underneath that same big sky.
She's gonna play a princess in the next song. You'll see.
I can show you the world, shining, shimmering, splendid. Tell me, princess, now when did you last let your heart decide? I can open your eyes, take you wonder by wonder, over, sideways, and under, on a magic carpet ride, a whole new world with new fantastic points of view. No one to tell us no, or where to go, or say we're only dreaming.
Keep going. Oh, she's sweet. I want her and him right there. Don't move. I like that. No, okay. We won't get into that. Ladies and gentlemen, Susan and I met, believe it or not, 25 and a half years ago on a cruise ship. She was performing in her own show and I was doing my own show. And quickly, like this. Why do I talk to you? You don't respond. It was very fast. Quick. 3 weeks. We were done. Locked in. Engaged. 3 months later, we were pregnant. No, that's not true. We did everything by the book. 9 months later. No. It was a long courtship. 6 months. Then we got married. Then came the baby. That's the way it works.
You're out of control.
I'm out of control. He's out of control! That's my Regis Philbin impersonation. Thank you, lady. That was free. It's not included in the show. I just did it because I had time. But anyway, after we met, it was very clear that we had something in common. And that is a love for musical theater. So for the next 2.5 hours, we're going to take you on a journey of musical theater, some roles that we had the opportunity to portray, and some beautiful songs that we truly love and are dear to our hearts. So this first one was a show by Stephen Sondheim called Follies. Thunderous round of applause, and this lady said she didn't like the show. Okay. It's all right. Lady, it's on videotape, but you're good. Don't worry. It's okay. But there was one song that was pretty good. You have to admit it. Susan's going to do it for us now, and it's called Losing My Mind.
About you, the coffee cup, I think about you, I want you so, it's like I'm losing my mind. The morning ends, I think about you, I talk to friends and think about you. And do they know? It's like I'm losing my mind. All afternoon, doing every little chore. Sometimes I stand in the middle of the floor, not going left, not going right. I dim the lights and think about you, spend sleepless nights to think about you. You said you love me, or were you just being kind? Or am I losing my mind? All afternoon, doing every little chore, the thought of you stays. Sometimes I stand in the middle of the floor, not going left, not going right. I dim the lights and think about you, spend sleepless nights to think about you. You said you loved me.
Hear me now, all the bleak and unbearable world, how abased and impotent as can be. And a knight with his banner now bravely unfurled, hurls down his gauntlet to thee. Hear me, demons and wizards and serpents of sin, all the dastardly doings are cast. For a noble endeavor is now to begin, and virtue shall triumph at last. I, Don Quixote, the Lord of La Mancha, my destiny calls and I go. And though that carry me onward whithersoever they blow, whithersoever they blow, onward to glory I'll go. Mississippi, here we all work while the boss men play, pulling them boats from the dawn till sunset, getting no rest till the judgment. Don't say nothing, but he must know something. He keeps on rolling, he just keeps rolling along. He don't plant taters, and he don't plant cotton, and them that plant some are soon forgotten. But old man River, he just keeps rolling along. You and me, we sweat and strain, bodies all aching and racked with pain. Get a little drunk and you land in jail. Get weary and sick of trying. I'm tired of living but scared of dying. And old man River, he just keeps rolling along. Attend the tale of Sweeney Todd. He served a dark and a vengeful god. He shaved the faces of gentlemen who never thereafter were heard of again. He trod a path that few have trod, did Sweeney Todd, the demon barber of Fleet Street. In 1979, Stephen Sondheim wrote a very macabre musical. And to set up the story for you, there was a young man, a barber, very talented. His name was Benjamin Barker. He lived in London in about 1885. It was a depression time in London in that era. And although he was a very talented barber, he and his wife could only afford a small little apartment above Mrs. Lovett's meat pie shop. Well, a local judge and his magistrate took a liking to Benjamin Barker's wife. And although she had a 2-year-old child, they took it upon themselves to set up Benjamin Barker, to send him away to the penal colony in Australia on false charges so that they could have their way with his wife and take possession of their young daughter. 15 years goes by, and Benjamin Barker is able to escape. And he comes back to the town. He comes back to the very meat pie shop where he hopes to find some trace of his wife and daughter, only to find out from Mrs. Lovett, still the owner of the meat pie shop, that his wife has poisoned herself. And the two-year-old girl was taken and being raised by this judge. So at this point in the musical, Sweeney Todd is seeking revenge. He's kind of angry. He's a little upset. A young man who he knew 15 years ago, who was a sort of apprentice to him, had come by, recognized him, and threatened to give him up to the judge if he didn't pay him off. Now known as Sweeney Todd, he takes his revenge out, his first kill, on this young man. And then, the question really remains, what would remain for all of us, what do you do now? Mrs. Lovett, you saw he made me do it.
Mr. Todd, what are we going to do about the body?
Don't worry about the body. Later on, when it's dark, we'll take him to some secluded place and bury him.
Well, we could do that, I suppose. But you know me. Bright ideas just pop into me head and I keep thinking. Seems a downright shame.
Shame?
Seems an awful waste. Such a nice plump frame. What's his name has. Laura can't be traced. Business needs a lift. Debts to be erased. Think of it as thrift, as a gift. If you get my drift, now seems an awful waste. I mean, with the price of meat, what it is, when you get it, if you get it.
Ha!
Good, you got it. Type, for instance, Mrs. Mooney and a pie shop. Business never better using only pussy cats and toast. And a pussy's good for maybe 6 or 7 at the most. And you really can't compare as far as taste.
Mrs. Lovett, what a charming, most independently practical and yet appropriate as always. Mrs. Lovett, how I live without you all these years, I'll never know.
Think about it, all the other gentlemen will soon be coming for a shine.
What the choice, how rare, oh, what's the sound of the world out there?
What, Mr. Todd, what, Mr. Todd, what is that sound?
Those crunching noises pervading the air.
Yes, Mr. Todd, yes, Mr. Todd, yes, all around.
It's man devouring man, my dear.
And who are we to deny any here?
Ah, these are desperate times, Mrs. Lovett, and desperate measures must be taken.
Here we are. Hot from the oven.
What is that?
It's priest. Have a little priest.
Is it really good?
Sir, it's too good, at least. Then again, it don't come, it sins of the flesh. So it's pretty fresh.
Awful lot of fat.
Only where it's sat.
Haven't you got poet or something like that?
No, you see, the trouble with poet is how do you know it's deceased? Try the priest.
Heavenly! Well, not as hearty as bishop, perhaps, but then not as bland as curate either.
Good for business, too. Always leaves you wanting more. Trouble is, we only get it on Sundays. Lawyer's rather nice.
If it's for a price.
Order something else, though, to follow, since no one should swallow it twice.
Anything that's lean.
No, but if you're British and loyal, you might enjoy Royal Marine. Anyway, it's clean, though of course a taste of wherever it's been.
It's that squire on the fire.
Mercy, no, sir, look closer, you'll notice it's grosser.
Looks thicker, more like vicar.
Now it has to be grosser, it's green.
History of the world, my love.
Save a lot of graves, do a lot of relatives' favor.
It's those below serving those up above.
Everybody shaves, so there should be plenty of flavor.
How gratifying for once to know
that those above will serve those down below. Now let's see. I believe we've got Tinker.
No, no, something pinker.
Tyler.
Something paler.
But
something subtler?
Potter?
Hotter.
Locksmith? Lovely bit of clock.
Maybe for a lark.
Then again, they're sweet. If you want it cheap and you like a duck, try the financier, peak of his career.
That looks pretty rank.
Well, he drank, it's a bank cashier. Last one really sold, wasn't quite so old.
Have you any beetle?
Next week, so I'm told. Beetle isn't bad till you smell it and notice how well it's been greased. Stick to priest. Now this one might be a bit strict, but then of course it's fiddle player.
No, no, this isn't fiddle player. It's piccolo player.
How can you tell?
It's piping hot.
The flower that burst.
History of the world, my sweet.
Oh, Mr. Todd, oh, Mr. Todd, what does it tell?
Is who gets eaten and who gets to eat.
And Mr. Todd, to Mr. Todd, who gets to sell?
And everybody goes down well with me.
Hey, now, since Marine doesn't appeal to you, how about Rear Admiral?
No, no, too salty. I prefer General.
With or without his privates. With his extra.
What is that?
It's fop. Finest in the shop. And we've got some shepherd's pie peppered with actual shepherd on top. And under the gun is the politician so oily. It's served with a doily. Have one.
Put it on a bun. Well, you never know if it's going to run.
Try a prior, private's dryer.
No, the clergy is really too coarse and too mealy.
An actor that's compactor.
Yes, and always arrives overdone. Well, come again when you have judge on the menu.
Wait, troop, we don't have judge yet, but I have something you'll fancy even better.
What is that?
Execution.
Have charity toward the world, my
goodness. Yes, yes, I know, my love.
We'll take the customers that we can get.
High born and low, my love.
We'll not discriminate great from small. We'll serve anyone, meaning anyone, meaning anyone, anyone. song's over. It's a long one, right?
Yes.
Yeah. What'd you say, encore? Oh, no. Baby, are you ready? It's hard to do Broadway without talking about one of the most successful musicals to ever, ever come out of London. It came out from a French couple. Close. Les Miserables. A wonderful, wonderful show. They did a movie about it a few years back. Did anybody get to see that? With Wolverine, what's his name? Hugh Jackman, and the other guy, Russell Crowe. He didn't crow too good in that, so not for me. To each his own. But we loved the show so much. I got to see the very first production of that in the National Theater in London. It was six, you think this show is long? It was 6 hours long. We're coming in like at 4:20. So ladies and gentlemen, here's our small tribute to Les Miserables.
Pain goes on and on, empty chairs at empty tables. Now my friends are dead and gone. Here they talked of revolution. Here it was they lit the flame. Here they sang about tomorrow, but tomorrow never came. From the table in the corner, I could see a world reborn, and they rose with voices ringing. I can hear them now, the very words that they had sung became their last communion at the lonely barricade at dawn. Oh, my friends, forgive me that I live and you are gone. There's a grief that can't be spoken. There's a pain goes on and on. Phantom faces at the window. Phantom shadows on the floor. Empty chairs and empty tables. My friends will speak no more. Oh, my friends, don't ask me what your sacrifice was for. Empty chairs and empty tables. Now my friends will sing no more.
Thank you. All right. Another name that goes synonymous with Broadway is a composer who's had, boy, probably 50 or more Tony Award winnings, hundreds of nominations. He's so good that his name has three names. Andrew, lady, you're getting good. I think you're sitting too close to him. He's rubbing off on you. Lisa's the answer couple. Awesome. Sir, Andrew Lloyd Webber. You like him? Wonderful shows, right? Let's think of some of them. Okay, next.
Cats.
Anybody here love cats? I mean the animal, not the show. Cat people. Okay, anything else? Jesus Christ Superstar. Anything else? What? Danita. Oh, Evita. Danita was her cousin. Well, we couldn't do anything with Broadway without including Andrew Lloyd Webber. So here's a couple of our favorite shows. Susan, sing this one, baby.
I'll try.
You go.
Midnight, not a sound from the pavement. Has the moon lost her memory? She is smiling alone. In the lamplight, the withered leaves collect at my feet, and the wind begins to blow. Memory, all alone in the moonlight, sunrise, I must think of a new life, and I mustn't give in. When the dawn comes, tonight will be a memory too, and a new day will begin. Burnt out ends of smoky days, the stale cold smell of morning, a street lamp dies, another night is over, another day is dawning. Touch me, you'll understand what happiness is. Look, a new day has begun.
I am of
inside your mind.
Those who have seen your face draw back in fear. I am the mask you wear.
It's me they hear. My spirit we'll be right back.
in this labyrinth when night is blind. The phantom of the rock is here inside my mind.
Sing for me, my angel of mute.
He's here.
Floating, falling, swimming.
sweet intoxication. Touch me, trust me, savor each sensation. Let the dream begin, let your darker side give in to the power of the music that I write. The power of the music of the night.
You love me.
You know I do. that's all I ask of you. Thank you. Have a seat. Have a seat. Thank you. We want to give you some. This is a beautiful song. It means so much to us. And it is a prayer for all of you, for every one of us tonight. For better things, a better life, more love, and more hope.
Did you have to make my poor old horse lose his shoe just before the sermon? That wasn't nice. It's enough you pick on me, Ted. Bless me with five daughters, a life of poverty. But what have you got against my horse? You know, sometimes I think when things are too quiet up there, you say to yourself, let's see what kind of mischief I can play on my friend Teddy. Oh, and my wife. My Goldie. As the good book says, heal us, O Lord, and we shall be healed. In other words, send us the cure. We've got the sickness already. I'm not really complaining. After all, with your help, I'm starving to death. Dear God, you made many, many poor people. I realize, of course, that it's no shame to be poor, but it's no great honor either. So what would have been so terrible if I had a small fortune? If I were a rich man, all day long I'd pretty, pretty come. If I were a wealthy man, I would have to work hard. If I were a pretty, pretty rich, idle, deedle, idle, idle man, I'd build a house with rooms by the dozen, right in the middle of the town. A fine tin roof with real wooden floors below. There would be one long staircase just going up, and one even longer coming down, and one more leading nowhere just for show. I fill my yard with chicks and turkeys and geese and ducks for the town to see and hear, squawking just as noisily as they can. And each loud would land like a trumpet on the ear, as if to say here lives a wealthy man. If I were a rich man, all day long I'd pretty, pretty come. If I were a wealthy man, I wouldn't have to work hard. If I were a pretty, pretty rich, idle, deedle, idle, idle man, I see my wife, my golden, looking like a rich man's wife, with a proper double chin, supervising meals to a heart's delight. I see her putting on airs and strutting like a peacock. Oh, what a happy mood she's in, screaming at the servants day and night. The most important men in town will come to call on me. They will ask me to advise them like Solomon the Wise. If you please, Lebedevia, pardon me, Lebedevia, posing problems that would cross the rabbi's eyes. Won't make one bit of difference if I answer right or wrong. When you're rich, they think you really know. If I were rich, I'd have the time that I lack to sit in the synagogue and pray, and maybe have a seat by the Eastern Wall. And I discuss the holy books with the learned men 7 hours every day. That would be the sweetest thing of all.
If I were a rich man, all day long I'd pay any loan. If I were a wealthy man, I wouldn't have to work hard. Lord who made the lion and the lamb, you decreed I should be what I am. Would it spoil some vast eternal plan if I were a wealthy man?
Once again, Andy and Susan.